The latest now on President Marcos's upcoming state visits to Indonesia and Singapore. The Philippine Foreign Affairs Department says Marcos will witness the signing of several key agreements in the areas of defense and culture in Indonesia. A comprehensive plan of action that will chart the bilateral priorities of the two countries will also be signed. In Singapore, Marcos will see the signing of agreements in counterterrorism and data privacy. Aside from meeting the neighbors or the leaders of both countries, President Marcos is also expected to meet with business leaders and Filipino communities. The DFA says Marcos's first overseas trip as president demonstrates the importance of the Philippines places on relations with its ASEAN neighbors. Marcos kicks off his inaugural state visits on September 4, Sunday.
Former Philippine Vice President Lenny Robredo invited to be a visiting fellow at Harvard University. Robredo will be among the Hauser leaders of the Harvard Kennedy School's Center for Public Leadership. Robredo is expected to give lectures, lead public events, and directly engage with students and other members of the Harvard community throughout the fall semester. Robredo says she is both thrilled and humbled to be given such space to share her advocacies and experiences. The Hauser Leaders Program, now on its eighth year, invites leaders in government, in private sector, and nonprofit organizations. Robredo will be joined by four other Hauser leaders, including former U.S. Representative Jane Harman. The Philippines logged 3,767 new COVID cases Thursday. The health department also reported 50 additional deaths. Active cases now stand at 22,259, the lowest in over a month. But officials warn more COVID patients who had already been vaccinated with two COVID doses are experiencing severe infections, highlighting the importance of getting boosted.
Dati, pag tinignan natin, at the onset, no, pag tinignan natin, almost 70 to 80% of those admitted with severe infections are unvaccinated. Ngayon, nakita natin na halos 50-50 na ang ating figures. 50% na bakunado, 50% na hindi bakunado. But this might spell, no, or give us that warning that immunity really is waning because we already have people vaccinated but are still being admitted in our hospitals and having severe infections.
President Ferdinand Marcos Jr. vows to improve the lives of Filipino nurses. Speaking during the 100th anniversary celebration of the Philippine Nurses Association, Marcos says his administration will address the wide gap or the wage gap among private and government nurses. He adds their current benefits are not enough.
As of 19 August of this year, the government has disbursed a total of 25.82 billion pesos worth of benefits to our healthcare workers, especially our nurses.
Sa palagay ko, kulang pa yan eh. Medyo hirap tayo sa pondo ngayon. Kaya sa ngayon, ganyan lang muna. Pero palagay ko, binubuhay nyo yung may sakit eh. Ibang usapan yan, walang mahirap lagyan ng balor, ng dolyar, ng piso, yung trabahong ginagawa ninyo.
Marcos also says government will open more slots for the deployment of Filipino nurses abroad. The Philippines earlier imposed a 7,500 deployment cap for healthcare workers going abroad due to the pandemic.
I think I am correct when I say no other country can boast of such a strong and capable nurses who are known not just for competence and dedication to this very noble calling of healthcare, but for their compassion and kindness. As we work hard to improve the state of our healthcare system at home, let us join hands to maintain our country's position as the gold standard when it comes to providing healthcare workers to hospitals and health facilities globally. We will open more slots for the deployment of nurses abroad while striving to improve opportunities domestically.